nature, humans are curious, adventurous, and ambitious. We seek to push the limits and explore the unknown. It is why we have mapped parts of the oceans, explored caves, and have footprints on the moon. Every single one of us has this drive. Julie Payette, a former Canadian astronaut, once said, "On ne peut pas arrêter le désir humain d'aller plus loin," which translates to, "We can't stop the human desire to go farther." She and many others have inspired the population not only to go out of this world, but to do the dreadful physics calculations in order to prove to the human race that the sky is not the limit. Good afternoon, judges, fellow competitors, ladies and gentlemen. We don't often hear about women working in the aerospace industry. However, they have been an enormous part in developing and enhancing space travel. This is evident in the movie Hidden Figures, where women solve complex mathematics by hand for the engineers. They had to calculate the rocket science behind sending someone into outer space, a place where nobody had gone before, so their accuracy was highly dependent on. Since they were so precise, more and more women were hired at the Langley Memorial Aeronautical Laboratory in Hampton, Virginia. Back in the 1960s, Margaret Hamilton led the group of people who created the software that landed man on the moon. She was a working mother while her husband studied law at Harvard University. While she was creating the routines that would eventually be inputted in the Apollo's command module computer, her four-year-old daughter slept on the floor at Hamilton's office. It was unusual for a woman in the 60s to work as a mother, but she did her best multitasking both her jobs. And it paid off too, as her programming was so well done that there were no trace of bugs and were later used in the future missions like the space shuttle program. There are not very many women aerospace engineers, but as you can see, the ones who are quite remarkable. There have been a total of 537 astronauts worldwide. 537. Yet, only 60 of them have been women. Moreover, only two of them, Canadian female. Despite the small percentage, women have still made a huge difference. At the beginning of the Mercury program in 1958, they were looking for anybody who was willing to take the risk and explore the unknown. However, they limited their selection to military test pilots only, which excluded females because military test pilots were only men back then. The National Aeronautics and Space Administration, commonly known as NASA, only started looking for women astronaut candidates in 1977. Sally Ride, at the age of 32, became the first American woman to go to space and the youngest NASA astronaut. Now, there have been younger cosmonauts, which are Russian astronauts. She still holds the title for the youngest NASA astronaut. In my introduction, I mentioned Julie Payette, a former Canadian astronaut. And like most astronauts, she's extremely talented and has an experienced background in aviation. She can speak German, Russian, Italian, Spanish, and is fluent in English and French. Furthermore, she is a licensed commercial pilot and has over 450 hours worth of flight time. That is equivalent to almost 19 days. So just imagine, from now until April 27th, that is the same amount of time she has spent as pilot in command. During her flight in the Discovery Space Shuttle back in 1999, she became the first Canadian astronaut to visit the International Space Station. Soon after she returned to Earth, she became the chief astronaut for the Canadian Space Agency. In early March 2015, I had the incredible opportunity to meet Wendy Lawrence, a retired NASA astronaut, at the event "The Sky's No Limit, Girls Can Fly Too." Upon hearing her stories and experiences with the space program, I became inspired to become an astronaut. I have always been passionate about astronomy, but the fact that I can actually go there above and beyond Earth's atmosphere motivated me to at least try for it. At the end of our chat, I asked for her signature, to which she wrote, "Madison, dare to dream." And that is exactly what I intend to do. That day, she not only inspired me, but hundreds of other young girls. As you can see, these talented women have worked hard for their accomplishments. They and many others have inspired the population to go out of this world. Because ultimately, we can't stop the desire to go farther.